Hi guys! So today I will show you my favorite improvements for the TiVo Tarantula. As you know, I made lots and lots of improvement videos. Some are a must-have, while others are a nice-to-have. So which ones are really needed? I made my list, of which, in my opinion, make all the difference. I divided the improvements into two different categories: upgrades and add-ons. In this video, I will cover the upgrades. Replacing the Y carriage acrylic part with a stiffer one is a must for me. The acrylic one bounces, shakes, wobbles too much when printing, and that will affect your printing quality. I decided to go with the carbon fiber one because it's very strong and light. It's lighter than the acrylic and lighter than the aluminum version, which translate in better inertia, which is good for faster accelerations. Replacing all acrylic parts is not a must, but I really recommend it. You get much better alignment in all your wheels, and because these parts don't break, you can secure them better. Like I said, you also have the aluminum option. But carbon fiber is better because it absorbs vibration much better than metal. And you don't want vibrations to spread through your system. I always preferred rails over wheels, but that doesn't mean that the wheels do a bad job. In the case of the Y-axis, because it has a big area, it's recommended to have a different system. A dual rail is the best option you can get, but for this, you need to make a big modification and buy more aluminum profiles, etc., etc. In my opinion, you can get away with just one rail. I bought this cheap one on eBay for 20 bucks. I heard many users say that these cheap rails don't last long, and they might be right. But mine is still rock solid and runs smooth. There are a few tricks to increase the rail lifespan. One of them is to have it well greased all the time. The other, and for me the most important, is the handling. If you don't stress the heat bed, you will not stress the rail. And the best way to do that is to always print on glass and be careful when installing and removing it. If you push, pull, twist the heat pad, your entire axis will suffer. Not only you will reduce the rail's lifespan, but you also will mess with your leveling adjustment. For me, it only makes sense to install the rail on the Y-axis. The X-axis will work just fine with the wheels since it's very light. The Z, on the other hand, would work better with rails, but the modification is not simple. I was going to mention the old ham coupler or the dual Z nut mount, but I decided not to include those here, but instead include the dual Z motor. And this is why. At the beginning, I had the need to use the old ham coupler. I noticed some Z wobbling, and only after installing the old ham coupler, I was able to eliminate that wobble. I also tested the dual Z nut mount, and also worked very well. So both are great choices, but when I installed the second Z motor, I decided to start from scratch and remove the old ham coupler. And at the end, I got perfect printing results. Since then, I'm running both lead screws with no old ham or dual Z nut mount. The old ham coupler helps you when you have a misalignment or slightly bent screw. It will move in X and Y to compensate. The old ham coupler also has the ability to disengage the Z in case it hits when moving down and save your printer from a crash. The dual Z will keep the entire horizontal gantry leveled all the time, and the movement will be smoother. Having only one lead screw at the side will create an imbalanced system, and wheels need to have a stronger grip to maintain the horizontal profile leveled. The flex coupling is holding all the weight, and in this imbalanced system, the coupling will take the bullet and might vary its length during the print, which results in problems with your print quality. When having just one lead screw on the side, it will need more force to raise the Z due to the imbalanced system. A center lead screw would need less force. But with two lead screws, you have a balanced system, and all the weight is being shared by the two flex couplers. First, install the second Z and make sure both lead screws are perfectly aligned. And if you still notice some Z wobbling, then add the oblong coupler. And that's it! This is my list. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Feel free to share your thoughts and leave your comments below. If you have a different list, let me know, share with me. And if you liked the video and want me to make more of these, hit the like button below.